Ram, Ram, Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram. विधि का विधान जान अनिला सहिए चाहे विधि राधे राम ताहे विधि सहिए हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सब बोलिए जोर से दीवान हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे
You should begin, then give it to Bangla school.
राधा भजने जदि मोती नहीं भेला कृष्ण भजना तब अकारण गेला
Oh, Namaom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Ite Namine
Krishna, 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 Krishna. कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महामदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं न माम शरणं
व्रजे. माय मिलियंस ऑफ टेंडर्स प्रणाम in the lotus feet of my Paramaradhyatam Nitya Leela Pravishtam Vishnupad Srishmat Bhakti Prakyan Kisho Goswami Maharaj and send millions of Dandat Pranati in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Nitya Leela Pravishtam Vishnupad Srishmat Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Here our class is fourth day. Fifth day. Everything is going on, Hari Katha, powerful. Today, in our program, Srivad Kirtanananda Prabhu has come, and fortunately today, Paramadvaiti Maharaj has also come. So our festival is so successful. Kirtanananda Prabhu to speak two words and then Vishnu Vidrohit Maharaj will speak.
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namini. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gormani Pachana Namaste Shunyari Paskachate Sattva. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adaita Gadadha Sri Vatsali Gopakta Gopakta. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. All glories to Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj. I intend to follow the instruction of Chaitanya Chaitamrita, when it says, let thy words be few. The essence of Krishna consciousness can be put in just a few words. Chant Hare Krishna and be happy. Stay out of politics. Chant Hare Krishna and be happy.
We are finished. Well, we wanted to hear some instructions. Then I am requesting Sri Bhakti Paramadvaiti Maharaj to speak something.
Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Namami. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini. Nirvishesha Shunyavati Paskachati Zatarini. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda. Panchakalpata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhavecha Evacha Patitanam Bhavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Thank you very much to allow me to be here today. Krishna Narayan Maharaj invited me to come and address today all the, as actually his secretary asked me to say some words about the Vishva Vaishnava Rajshava and what we are trying, what service we are trying to offer to the Vaishnava community through this Shabha. And I was very enlivened to come here for that purpose and to hear from Srila Narayan Maharaj and all the assembled Vaishnavas to get their association a great inspiration. Very easy to address an assembly of dedicated Vaishnavas. One feels shy, ashamed. One cannot offer any tangible, elevating words to the devotees. But of course, simply to remember the great souls is always my only solace. So today, as we are here in the spirit of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Lord Nityananda Prabhu, in the spirit of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and all the acharyas, that very spirit which we have noticed to manifest wherever wonderful devotees try to transmit their nectar of the Gurudev to others, that we feel very comfortable. And I want to specifically, we always say Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Dinamani, offer our obeisances to our Diksha Guru, Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. But we are made up by the mercy of so many Vaishnavas. And Srila Prabhupada entered his Nitya Leela such a long, long time ago. And in a somewhat hopeless stage, after the departure of our Guru Deva, we met many other senior Vaishnavas. As a matter of fact, the other day I was remembering that I visited Srila Narayan Maharaj in 1984, after we had just decided that we had to continue our spiritual life with more autonomy and more execution of our own criteria, rather than to go on in an atmosphere where Vaishnava apparat had become rampant. And there was no juice, there was no ras, there was no nectar in those days. The temple offices were places like my godbrother just said, where only politics were being discussed from morning to evening, and was wondering, what am I doing here? So I think some of you may have shared these moments also. So then I went to Mathura and I met Srila Narayan Maharaj, and I said, you know, I just left and I'm now on my own. And what recommendation you have for me? You want to help me? At that time he said, you better go to see Srila Srila Maharaj. So, of course, that recommendation was very welcome to me, by me, because I had read Sri Guru in His Grace. This book, this historical book, which came from the talks of Srila Bhakti Rakakshila Deva Goswami Maharaj, which I think changed the way of seeing Vaishnavism, Vaishnava transcendental teachings, for many of us. At least for me, it changed my life and my view on many things. I eternally indebted to Atreya Rishi Prabhu, who gave me this book when I didn't expect it. And so I was able to meet Srila Bhakti Rakakshila Maharaj, and I want to offer my humble obeisances to the sweetness of every word I was able to receive from him, to give us strength to go on and somehow other to take up a responsibility which we didn't feel at all capable of carrying out. But the question was there, who was going to go and do that job of preaching? And the first instruction I received from Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada was, the Vani is more important than the Vapu. You are out far from me, but you're preaching. That is the most dear to me, so don't try to become my personal secretary and give up your preaching. So, because I had in mind that maybe I could also be close to him, you know, like every disciple desires to be a secretary and give Gurudev a massage and all this, you know. But the first thing he said, you go and preach and you do that for the rest of your life. So somehow or other, that's what that was our lifeline, what we cling on to. And so Srila Bhakti Rakakshila Maharaj, he encouraged us so much. He gave us so much, so much freedom, so much love, so much trust. Again, the same love and trust which Srila Prabhupada had already given to us, because without it you can't go out and do anything. So that was wonderful. And I just wanted to give this thanks to, even though Srila Bhakti Lakshmi Maharaj didn't like it at all, if you would say thank you, he would smash you. Oh, you mean thank you and then you go away. And no, there's a commitment. If you got anything and you feel that you got, then you're committed. Then you stay here and do service for the rest of your life. So thank you was not appreciated. So I'm not saying thank you. I'm saying I'm committed. I want to go on, and I pray to get the mercy of great Vaishnavas so that I can achieve sincerity in devotional service. And then, once again, Srila Prabhupada left the world 1977, Srila Bhaktivedanta Srila Maharaj left the world 1988. And again we became morose, and again we thought, now how is this going to go on now? Now what's the next? So, in that difficult moment, another beautiful Vaishnava appeared on the horizon in a very wonderful way, in an extraordinary, humble way. Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, he showed us how wonderful it is to serve the Vaishnavas, and so many things he showed to us, and he received us with his open arms, with his embrace, and reminding us of all the details of Vaishnava life. For example, Srila, I share this with you, it's not very philosophical, but to me it means a lot. Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj used to have a little box. And in that box he had dust of every holy place and a few bottles with a little water from all the holy places and of course a little, everything was there. The whole town was there. And if you watched him, he was making parikrama with his little box. And to each dust, maybe ate a little, and a prayer to Vrindavan, a pryer to Puri, a prayer to Haridas Thakur Samadhi, a prayer, it was everything. And he was so entertained doing that. It was so sweet, so wonderful to see how everything was so important to him. Things which we may brush over easily. Just like association with devotees can become so significant if we avoid to minimize them, ever. Or any one of them. So I saw that it manifested in his personality. He would love everybody. He wouldn't minimize me. He was emphasizing education. He was saying very important. We are all one. We all have the same chance. By the mercy of the holy name, he said, it doesn't matter whether you're born in the west or the east, we have all the same chance, the same duties to follow and serve Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lord Nityananda Prabhu. And we have to make very careful, make efforts that the new generations will be well educated in the science of Krishna consciousness. I mean, he was a publisher, he was working in the Gaudiya Math publication department, and he was the person who was installing practically all the deities in the Gaudiya Math. They were installed by him. He was like the expert on these rituals and all these wonderful things. And we were so lucky. And while I was with Srila Sridharmaj and while I was with Srila Puri Maharaj, no doubt I met so many other Vaishnavas. Srila Narai Maharaj came regularly visiting there. And so it was a sweet meeting of all the Vaishnavas. And that sweet meeting, that's an ongoing affair. That is, to me, that is the spirit of Vishwa Vaishnava Rajshava. And of course then we go home and we work hard. It's not only that all day we meet and have nice talks. That's also nice, but we all have to go and do so many things to develop and organize whatever our Gurudev has given us as an assignment so we can have a substantial presentation of Krishna consciousness. But personally, to my own heart's feeling, it is such an important thing that we do things in such a way that the general public will recognize the Vaishnavas as the lovers of God and the servants of humanity and the servants of truth. I personally feel that was how my Gurudev came for. And I mean, of course he wanted to give pure love to Krishna, to his disciples as the topmost priority, but he wanted the whole world to be Krishna conscious. He wanted everybody to have a respect, and whenever we as his disciples did something which caused the opposite, that the people in the world were not so impressed by the devotees, then that would upset him. He didn't like that at all. He made many times. One time he was approached by Tripurari Maharaj, what is the secret of book distribution? How can we distribute more of these transcendental literatures to the people? And he made very clear that he didn't mean, his interest was not in numbers of distribution. His interest was that the people would really, really be captivated in the heart by the devotees' presentation. And that they want, nowadays, even book distribution is not so substantially important as in those days, because people can get all the Vaishnava books practically for free on the internet. They can load down the entire Bhagavatam, which at that time was a dream. We were enthused as brahmacharis, go out and make sure every house has a book of Srila Prabhupada. That was our driving force, to go out from morning to the night, winter and summer, to go door to door in the shopping malls and giving the people a book and begging them to give a donation. Like real beggars, but loving beggars, because we only begged them for their own benefit. We didn't need anything from them. We didn't want to avoid working. So this spirit of compassion, generosity, association of devotees, this love, and when you meet other devotees and you feel just even more encouraged. Like, who could not be encouraged seeing such a wonderful amount of devotees here together chanting and dancing? It's not possible. So in this way, I'm also grateful that somehow or other it never stops. And then there'll be another Vaishnava and another Vaishnava and another Vaishnava. And I hope, I pray, that when I have to give up this body, there'll be Vaishnavas and tell me, think of Krishna. Don't forget Prabhupada. Do something in the last moment. That is my prayer. And I'm so thankful. I'm very impressed by Srila Narayan Maharaj sacrificing himself, his health, so much to be with all of us. This is a very stalwart example for because it's not easy, not only to travel and preach, but to tolerate all the headaches which come from the conditioned souls. That is really some amazing tolerance has to be there, amazing love, and we pray to get this love so we can serve our Gurudev also. Thank you very much for your Sangha, for your association. Hare Krishna.
Now, we are coming to our Bhagavad classes. Yesterday I told that Mother Yashoda wanted to give fresh and sweet butter to Krishna so that he should not go and steal butter from anywhere. So now she was churning yogurt and singing, being absorbed in Krishna's sweet pastime. Govinda
Damo Dharmade Ji, Govinda Damo Dharmade Ji.
Krishna was sleeping in the morning in Brahma Muhurta. He heard this song. His nature is that anywhere, any devotee can sing, being observed, he cannot stay there. So he wanted to come. He saw here and there, oh, where is mother? I'm hungry. I want to take her breast milk, but he could not find. He began to weep very loudly. Mother will hear and then will come. But she was totally absorbed in singing. So Krishna began to try come from pain. But he can jump from the sky to ocean in Sukha Roop.
In both incarnation.
He can jump from there. But he cannot come down from the way. Anyhow, he can fight with Hiranyakasipu and others. But he cannot. He can take Govardhana on his finger. But now he cannot come down from this. Anyhow, by difficulty, he came down. Crying more. But Yashoda mother was not hearing. Then what became? Afterward?
Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurum Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Kriveni Namaha. So this very beautiful and well-known pastime of Sri Krishna, Yasodanandan Krishna in Vrindavan, Srila Gurudev is beginning to set the scene for this beautiful pastime. As he told, Sri Krishna at that age was very tiny, and it was very difficult for him to even slide down from the bed. He had to slide down on his belly, coming down on his little legs, and coming down to the floor. And when he came down to the floor, just like a little child is looking for his mother when he is woken up, so Krishna, he was rubbing his eyes, and tears were coming from his eyes. And the kajal that Mother Yashoda puts, the eyeliner, blackish eyeliner around Krishna's little lotus eyes, oh, it was becoming rubbed all over his cheeks by his hands, and his chest, his beautiful lotus chest, had these teardrops coming on them. And in this way, little Krishna began to walk looking for his mother. Then he came into the room where his mother was stirring the pot of milk on the stove. Because as we heard yesterday, Srila Gurudev explained that Mother Yashoda was concerned about these reports that she was receiving from the elderly gopis in Braj that, oh, Krishna is such a butter thief and yogurt thief, and he is coming to their houses and stealing. So Mother Yashoda, although she didn't fully believe this, but nevertheless she thought, oh, if he is going to some other houses, why he should do this? I will make very, very special yogurt. And as Gurudev described yesterday, she went and personally milked the cow. She brought this milk, brought it to the stove, and began to boil this milk so that she could prepare and make it into yogurt. And from that yogurt, she would make very beautiful butter, very sweet butter. And then with this, she would serve Krishna and satisfy Krishna. So now Mother Yashoda, who was stirring this pot of milk on the fire, suddenly little Krishna came up to her and he began to pull on her sari, indicating that he wanted to suck her breast milk. So Mother Yashoda, she left the pot there and she brought Krishna onto her lap. And she sat brought Krishna next to her breasts and began to feed him her breast milk. She covered her the head of Krishna with her sari, and she began to gaze upon the beautiful face of her child, so sweet, so wonderful, and so satisfied to be there on his mother's lap. But suddenly, at the same time that Mother Yashoda was breastfeeding Krishna, suddenly she noticed that the milk on the stove, it was starting to boil up. and starting to come over the pot into the fire. So our acharyas have explained what was happening. This milk, also in Braja, all the objects in Braja are transcendental servants of Krishna. And this milk was also thinking that, oh, how will I ever have a chance to serve Krishna? Because here I'm seeing that Mother Yashoda, she's serving her breast milk to Krishna. And Mother Yashoda's capacity of giving breast milk to Krishna is like a vast, unlimited ocean. And Krishna's desire to drink that milk is also unlimited. He has such an unlimited capacity to consume that milk. So then how will I have a chance to serve Krishna? And at this point, the milk decided, then I will simply give up my life. I will commit suicide into the fire. And the milk began to boil over into the fire. So Mother Yashoda, she's noticing this, and Mother Yashoda also has compassion for all, and she wants to see that all will have the opportunity to serve her beloved Krishna. So Mother Yashoda, very quickly, she put Krishna down, and she ran quickly to the fire, and now she was looking after the milk. But Krishna, at that moment, that he was suddenly put down by his mother onto the floor, he became upset. And he felt, oh, my mother is neglecting me like this. And just like a stubborn child and pouting, Krishna thought, oh, well then, if she is doing this to me, then I will have to go and make some mischief. So Krishna went into the room where Mother Yashoda keeps the yogurt pots. In India, when they make yogurt, they also put them into clay pots, and they hang them sometimes from the ceiling, and some of them are on the floor. So when Krishna came into the yogurt pot room, oh, then he saw one pot of yogurt on the floor, and he took one pestle, where you have a grinding mortar and pestle, and he took this heavy object, and he hit the pot, breaking the pot. At that moment, the white, beautiful yogurt began to flow out from the pot all over the floor like a stream. And Krishna was observing how beautiful this was. Then Krishna, he began to take this yogurt, and there were also some monkeys nearby. Krishna was also feeding some of the monkeys, and his little lotus feet were walking in this puddle of yogurt and making little footprints all over the room like this. So, in this way, Krishna was very satisfied and happy. But Mother Yashoda, now when she took care of the pot, she suddenly came back and she found that Krishna was gone. So now, she began to search. Where is little Krishna? And she went over to where that room was, and inside of the entryway of the room, she saw these little footprints of Krishna's from the yogurt. And she thought, aha, so he is here. Now Mother Yashoda began to think, what is this? All these reports from the neighborhood elderly gopis, they have some truth in them. Perhaps my son is such a yogurt and butter thief. So then, from a distance, very carefully, like a cat, Mother Yashoda was creeping up very quietly. And she also picked up one stick nearby in her hand. And little Krishna was sitting there, and he was taking the yogurt, scooping it out of the pot, and enjoying this yogurt. And when he was busily absorbed in this way, suddenly the monkeys that were nearby, they gave some indication to Krishna. And he suddenly turned around, and then he saw Mother Yashoda there. And Mother Yashoda had a stick in her hand. So Krishna, very quickly, he got up from that place, and now he went running outside of the room. He dodged by Mother Yashoda, and he ran outside of the room. And now Mother Yashoda turned, and she began to run after Krishna with this stick in her hand. So Krishna was running. He ran outside of the house. He ran into the courtyard. And now, in the town of Braja Vrindavan, Mother Yashoda began to chase after Krishna. And all of the neighborhood gopis and the neighborhood people, they began to see this amazing sight, that little Krishna with his tiny little legs was running very fast, and Mother Yashoda is chasing after Krishna and trying to catch him with the stick in her hand. And Krishna is running, and he's going in a zigzag way so that Mother Yashoda cannot catch Krishna. And she's trying and laboring very hard, because Mother Yashoda was extremely beautiful and very shapely, with large hips and breasts, and it was not so easy for her to run after Krishna. But Krishna was running in a zigzag way, so he couldn't be caught. So as he was running, then he began to look back, and he saw Mother Yashoda coming, and he was looking very frightened like this. But finally, from behind, Mother Yashoda finally ran up, and she caught Krishna. And now Krishna was standing there very afraid, and no maya maya, like this. He was saying, no mother, please don't beat me, don't beat me. And Mother Yashoda understood, oh, Krishna is very frightened that I have this stick in my hand. So then she put the stick down. And she said, oh, now I have understood, actually you are a butter thief. So I know that I must give you some kind of punishment, and I must detain you so that you cannot create any more mischief. And so those who were the accomplice in your task, this mortar and pestle, you were climbing on top of this mortar to try and get these yogurt pots. So now I will tie you to this grinding mortar, and this way you will be kept safely here. So Mother Yashoda was thinking of Krishna's protection, and she was thinking also that Krishna should get some kind of punishment so that he learns. So then in this way, Mother Yashoda decided, okay, now I'm going to try to tie Krishna to this grinding mortar. And she took some rope, and she tied it around the grinding mortar.
Thank you. Not here?
No.
He's coming. The Sotaman is going to find Krishna. Krishna is waiting. Is it bhakti to make me Krishna?
Yes.
Guru Vai Gora Chandraya Adikaya Tadali Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Nama. First of all, I offer obeisances to Lotus Feet of Guru Pada Padma from Vishnu Pada Sisimad Bhaktiran Narayan Goswami Maharaj.
Chaitanya Vaishnava. What is the definition of bhakti? And then tell Yashoda Ma is going to bind him to chastise. Krishna is weeping. How will you kill him?
Sri Rupa Goswami has described Anyabilasita Sunyam Jnana Karmadi Navatam Anakulena Krishna Anushilam Bhaktir Uttama. To keep very short, bhakti means to do that which is what is for the benefit of Krishna, not necessarily which will appear to make Krishna happily externally. For example, we gave the example on the first day when Ravan was fighting with Ram. Then Ram, he also is Bir Purush, he likes to fight. So he felt great happiness in the battle with Ravan. But we cannot call this bhakti, because Ravan was actually trying to kill Ram. In the same way, Mother Yashoda, even though she is threatening to beat Krishna, and Krishna is weeping, it's called Uttam Bhakti, of the topmost class. Why? Because Mother Yashoda is thinking, if I do not tie up my son, then his mind is so disturbed, maybe he'll run off into the forest and become lost. Or I should chastise my son and make him good. This is called Vatsali Ras. Where Mother Yashoda, she has forgotten that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Krishna has also forgotten that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Both are dancing under the influence of Prema Bhakti, Yoga Maya. So this is a very high example of Prem. Prema yache bande radio bata jahan netre jaha deke deke tumar. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, the pure devotee has bound Krishna with the rope of love. Therefore, Nayam Shri Api Bhagavan, Nayam Bharichi Na Baba, Na Anga Shri, Na Shri Api Anga Sangshaya, Prasari Lebede Gatre Bandabat Tad Muktidat. The mercy given to Madhya Soda was not given even to Lakshmi, who always stays on the body of Krishna. What to speak of Na Bharichi Na Baba, nor Lord Brahma, nor Lord Shiva, because only Madhya Soda could tie Bhagavan, who gives mukti to everyone. And Krishna frees everyone from the bondage of material existence, but Madhya Soda could bind that person who has no inside and no outside, the all-pervading Lord. Therefore,
very good.
Thank you. Have you heard my question?
That Yashoda Mai went to bind Krishna. Krishna is waiting. She is chastising. She, Krishna was taking the breast milk of Yashoda. And Yashoda, by cost of air, sit down. So powerful Krishna. Oh. And Yashoda Maya went, how this is? Is it this bhakti? And after that,
Om Gyana Turandhasa Gyanandaraslaka Chakshurangalitam Vena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. So Srila Gurudev is raising the point that Madhya Yashoda, she is taking a stick and threatening Krishna. When he wants to drink from her breast milk, then she put him down, though he is so powerful that Putana could not put him down. Who has the strength of 60,000 elephants? Putana said, leave me, child. But she could not put him down. And Madhya Yashoda, with only one hand, put him down. And Krishna was upset. Is it bhakti or not? So Srila Rupa Goswami Pada has given the definition of bhakti. Anya vilashita shunyam jnana kama janavaratam anukulyena krishnanu shilanam bhaktir uttama. The continuous, unbroken cultivation of all endeavors of the body, mind and words and of transcendental moods, which are meant exclusively for the benefit of Krishna, completely devoid of even the slightest smell of any other desire, and not covered by karma, jnana, yoga, etc. That is called uttama bhakti. So, if one will say that activities that give pleasure to Krishna are bhakti, then a defect will come in the definition. There are two types of defects that can befall a definition. One is called avyapti dosh, the other is called ati vyapti dosh. Avyapti dosh means that the definition is too narrow to explain what bhakti is, because there'll be areas of bhakti which don't fit within the definition. So it's too narrow, avyapti. It does not cover everything which is included under bhakti. And ati vyapti dosh means that the definition is overextended, the fault of overextension of a definition. In other words, it will include things which are not bhakti. So if we'll say that the activities which give happiness to Krishna, this is bhakti, then the both defects will be there. Why? Because here, Madhya Yashoda, she loves Krishna, but she's not giving happiness to him. He's crying, he's afraid, he's trying to run away, even. So Madhya Yashoda's activity would not fit inside the definition of bhakti. Bhakti is just giving happiness to Krishna. So that would be the avyapti dosh. On the other hand, when Chanur and Mustik, the wrestlers in the arena of Kamsa, were beating Krishna, oh, he liked that. He was tasting virarasa, the heroic fighting mood, and he was happy. But they have no love for Krishna. So their activity is not bhakti. So if just giving happiness to Krishna was the definition of bhakti, then Chandra and Mustik would be doing bhakti. So this is not true. This would be the defect of ativyapti dosha, overextension of the definition. So what is bhakti? Bhakti is the Krishna anushilanam, the cultivation activities in relation to Krishna, but those activities must be anukulyena. Anukulyena means sometimes the idea is given favorable, but more accurately, our Purvacharyas, especially Srila Vishnu Chakrabarti, the absence of antagonism. So even though Chandra and Mustik give happiness to Krishna, they're antagonistic to him. So they do not fall in the category of pure bhakti. Anupulyena Krishna Nushilanam. And Madhya Yashoda, though she makes Krishna become afraid, and he's crying, but it's not immediate happiness, but ultimate happiness, because Madhya Yashoda is thinking, from my breast milk, I cannot make kheer and cheese, paneer, and so many other, I cannot make butter from the breast milk. And Krishna likes butter and all of these things very much. So Madhya Yashoda put him down and went to save the milk so that she could give all these wonderful preparations to Krishna. Therefore, it is considered to be Uttama Bhakti.
After that, Yashoda Maya told them to bring roe and she tried, but two on roe. So, if I'm 42 on roe.
So when Madhya Yashoda, she ran after Krishna, quickly she caught him. Hey, who has broken the pots? Oh, you have done it, mother, with your ankle belts. With your bracelets on your ankle belts. Who was feeding the monkeys? Who creates the monkeys, feeds the monkeys? Krishna was very... Oh, you're a thief. You're a chore. Krishna said, there's no chore in my dynasty. What? Because he heard his mother and father speaking. And in the dynasty of Madhya Yashoda, there was one person called Chor Ghosh. There's no chore in my dynasty. Maybe there's a chore in your dynasty. Madhya Yashoda, oh, okay. Then she thought, oh, if I take the stick, then he'll be very much afraid and he'll grow up to be maladjusted. So she threw down the stick, but she thought, I must punish him. Let me tie him with a rope. So she brought him inside and she thought Krishna was stealing butter, but he had one accomplice. That was the grinding mortar. He was standing on the grinding mortar to steal the butter. So both of them are guilty. They should be punished by being tied together. So Madhya Yashoda, she called for her sakis to bring some rope, and she took the rope and put it around Krishna. But when she came to tie it, it was two fingers too short. So she took another rope, tied it together, again put it around, again two fingers too short. She took all the ropes in the house, tied them together, again two fingers too short. She told her friends, go to your house, bring some ropes from there. He came, all the ropes in the whole of Braj, every rope was tied together. Again, two fingers too short. So Srila Gurudev is saying, what is the meaning, what is the significance of two fingers too short? It means that Krishna can only be bound by prema. And in order to attain prema, our own endeavors will not be enough. We'll have to do sadhana, but sadhana will not be enough. We need kripa, Krishna's mercy. So Krishna's mercy will come. But if one will sit around all day waiting for it to come, also it will not come. So both things are required. Sadhana, our own practices, and in addition to that, kripa. These are two fingers whereby Krishna can be bound. So an example is given. Two types of logic. Marjanyai and Marakatanyai. Cat logic, kitten logic, sorry, and monkey logic. You know that the kitten is carried here and there by the mother. Kitten can sleep, and the mother takes the kitten in the mouth and carries him here and there. But the monkey, the baby monkey, has to hold on tight to the mother, and the mother will not do anything. She will jump from tree to tree, and she will not do anything. The baby monkey will have to hold on very tight. And if he will drop, oh, unqualified baby, never mind, go to the next tree. So the baby monkey has to do everything, and the baby kitten has to do nothing. So some people think, oh, by our sadhan, we do everything to attain God. And some people think we cannot do anything. We can only say, oh, when will God be merciful to me? But the real answer is combination of both ideas. So that is given by the example. If a man has fallen into a well, and someone will come with a rope, and throw the rope, say, oh, catch this rope, I'll pull you out. If the man doesn't hold the rope, he cannot be pulled out. But if he holds the rope very tightly, and the other person does not pull, then also he will not come out. So the holding on to the rope means our sadhana, our practices, to follow the order of Guru and Vaishnav. But it is not enough. When we are following them, then only by their mercy can they pull us out. So we try to do our sadhana, and Srila Gurudev, by his mercy, he pulls us out of the well of this material world to send us back home to Goloka Vrindavan.
In this Bhagavad Katha, there are so many hidden things. Our Goswamis has revealed this to whole world. Mother Yashoda, why this is told in Srimad Bhagavad Vyasadeva has told? Hearing these sweet pastimes, a greed may come to serve Krishna like Mother Yashoda. These Harikathas are so sweet and powerful, very sweet for Karna Rasayan, and if meaning is known, then heart Rasayan. So a greed must come. After that, the sweet pastimes of Krishna with gopis will come. Rasleela will come. Gopi Geet will come. Brahma Geet will come. Uddhav Sandesh will come. So many things will come. Then hearing all these things, a greed must come. This is the speciality of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami followers. If they will hear this katha, powerful katha, they will remember these things. And Krishna will be controlled by this. That is why it has been written in Srimad Bhagavatam. Especially, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came mercifully, karunaya vatirnaha kalau. In this Kali Yuga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came mercifully to distribute what unnata ujjala rasam Sri Bhakti Sriyam. Sri Bhakti, unnata ujjala parkiya bhava. The mode of gopis, especially Srimati Radhika, Madanakya bhava up to, we cannot obtain Madanakya bhava. But something like Manjari, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, mercifully distributed in this world, new thing. Before that, Ramanu, Madhvacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbaditya, Jayadev, Goswami, and so many came in this world, but they have not distributed this prema. Inspired, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired in the heart of Rupa Goswami, and then he tried and see Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Thapitam Jaina Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadam Mahiyam Gadavisham Sapadam. See Chaitanya Mahaprabhu established. In his books, in Bhakti Rasami Sindhu Ujjvalyan, he has made the paribhashik slokas, definitions, like in Srimad Bhagavatam, Ete Chanskala Punsa Krishnastu Bhagavan. In this way, Rupa Goswami, what is Shraddha? What is Nishtha? What is Rati? What is Asakti? What is Rati? What is Prem? What is Sneh, Man, Pranay, Rag, Anurag, Bhav, Maham? He has made all definition. So whole world, all the Sampradaya, even Mayavadi also, they quote Rupa Goswami. Otherwise, they can establish their books. They are very lucky to come in his time. Try to have that mood what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has written. That is why in two slokas everything has been told. First, tattva. Where? Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Amnaya praha tattvam harimiha paramam sarvasaktim arasabdhim tadbhinan shasya jivan prakritikavalitan tadbhimukshal bhavam vedabhed satalam api hare sadhanam suddha bhaktim sadhyam tatpriti meve ityupadasi pura. Oh, you should explain this issue.
Srila Gurudev is citing the shloka from which is written by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It's called Dasmul Tattva. Dasmul means the 10 essential truths or principles. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's entire philosophy that he presented to the world is unique in this regard, and the acharyas have seen that these 10 principles are the main presentation of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophy. So first of all, Amnaya Praha Tattvam Harim Iha Paramam Sarva Shaktim Rasabdhim. First he begins with Amnaya. Amnaya is referring to the proof or the praman by which the other 9 truths will be proven and established. Amnaya, it means the Vedic truths which have come from the Vedas and Upanishads, Puranas, etc., received through the sampradaya of the Guru Parampara, disciplic succession, and approved by them, which means that not necessarily all of the statements of the Vedas are accepted in this context of Amnaya, because in some of the Vedic literatures they are written for those who are in the even in the Tamagun, and some for Rajagun, like this. Some of the Vedic literatures are encouraging persons to worship Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, or different demigods. But only the teachings of the Vedas, which are proving these 9 different essential principles, that is called Amnaya. So, what are those principles? Amnaya praha tattvam harim iha paramam sarva shaktim rasabdhim. That Sri Hari, Supreme Personality of Godhead, is Hari, Krishna, and He is the Paramam, He is the Supreme Truth, Tattva Paramam, and Sarva Shaktim, He is the source of all potencies, everything that exists, all energies, all Shaktis, they are emanations from Him. Rasabdhim, He Himself is the unlimited, infinite ocean of transcendental rasa, rasa abdhi. So the, just as in the Vedas it is stated, akil rasamrita murti, that absolute truth, Sri Krishna, is the very embodiment, personification of all rasa.
So then, tad vinamshams cha jiva prakriti kavalitam tad vimuktams cha bhavat. Then it explains that the jiva souls who are within this world are called vibhinamsha jivas. They are separated parts and parcels of Krishna. That Supreme Absolute Truth, Hari, expands himself in unlimited incarnations and expansions, which are all called Svamsha. They are non-different than his own self. They are one Supreme Tattva. Just like the other day, we were discussing this point about Krishna being Advay Gyan Paratattva, the Supreme, one, undivided Supreme Absolute Truth, and everything that exists ultimately is himself. But in the context of understanding the jiva souls, they are called vibhinamsha jivas. They are separated parts and parcels, and they have some difference with Krishna. In quality, they are very minute, whereas Krishna is infinite. In quantity, they are minute. Krishna is infinite in quantity. But in quality, they are the same as Krishna. So, prakriti kavalitam, tadvinamsham shajivam prakriti kavalitam tadvimuktam shabhava. And in this category of jivas, there are two types. Some of them are covered by prakriti. That means maya shakti, this material energy. All the jiva souls within the material worlds, they are all covered by this material energy in the form of the gross material body which we possess and the subtle material body of mind, intelligence, and false ego, ahankar. So these conditioned souls, they are constitutionally the same as the eternally liberated souls, but because they are emanating from the tatashta position, the marginal position between the spiritual world and the material world, they can go either direction. So in the two categories of jivas, some are covered by prakriti and some tadvimuktam shabhava, some are eternally liberated. They are never touched by this external potency. Then, beda beda prakasham sakalamapi sadhanam shuddha bhaktim. Beda beda prakasham. This is the very unique presentation of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophy, which takes into consideration all of the previous commentaries of all the four Vaishnava Acharyas, Ramanuja, Madhvacharya, Vishnuswami, and Nimbaditya. These four Acharyas they gave their commentaries on Vedanta Sutra, and there they discussed this question about the difference and the non-difference of ourselves, the living entities, in our relationship with the Supreme Absolute Being. So, but they had some different perspectives from which they were viewing. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he gave the perfect understanding of Vedanta philosophy in the form of Achintya Beda Beda Tattva. This means that the Absolute Truth is actually simultaneously different and also non-different from his emanations. And this very fact, being simultaneously different and non-different, is not actually possible to understand with the material mind. Therefore, it is called achintya, inconceivable. So, the Absolute Truth is eternally different than his emanations, his shakti, because he himself, he never changes. He is constantly the same, the Absolute Truth. But his shakti, this transforms into so many other varieties of forms and shapes. So Krishna and his shakti, shakti shakti mator abheda. Ultimately, there is no difference between Krishna and his shakti. Just like the sun is not different than the sun rays. The sun rays have heat and light, and the sun also has heat and light. And there's no meaning to the existence of the sun without the sun rays, and vice versa also. They exist simultaneously. But at the same time, there is a difference, because the sun globe is unlimitedly powerful and very full of fiery, burning power. If you have the sun globe near to our planet, everything will be burnt. But through the sun rays, very nice heating can come from that. So there is a difference in quantity of potency. So like this, Achintya Bheda Bhed Tattva is the essential understanding that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave in this world to understand the whole truth of the Vedic philosophy and absolute truth. So Bheda Bheda Prakasham Sakalam Api Sadhanam Shuddha Bhaktim. How to realize the Supreme Absolute Truth, Krishna. How to come to establish one's relationship with Him, and how to attain one's eternal position as a servant of His, which is actually the constitutional position of every jiva soul, that jivar sarupoi krishner nityadas. They are all eternal servants of Krishna. So therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained in his philosophy that the process, the sadhanam, the method by which the jiva soul can attain this position is called shuddha bhakti, pure devotion, pure love for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This week we had so many discussions about this subject, and just now also Srila Gurudev Prem Prayojan Prabhu explained this verse, Anya Bilashita Shunyam, and how this understanding, what is the definition of pure bhakti? So, without understanding this, what is pure bhakti, someone may attempt to approach the Absolute Truth, but they'll be unsuccessful. Because if they mix any other motivations into their attempt to approach the Supreme Truth, jnana, karma, if their bhakti is covered by any of those, they'll not be successful. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, sadhanam shuddha bhaktim. That the process is to perform pure bhakti, uttam bhakti, unalloyed bhakti. And then, tat priti, I forget the last line. Sadhya tat priti. So, the final principle in this dasmul tattva is called sadhya. Sadhya is that goal through which, through the sadhan that you're performing, you are aiming for, your aim and object of your practice. It is called sadhya. So what is sadhya? Sadhya is priti. This Sanskrit word priti means pure love, or in other words, prem, Krishna prem. So priti is actually the ultimate goal of every jiva soul's existence and life. And no jiva soul can ultimately live without this even for a moment. Therefore, even within this world, everyone is searching for love, searching for affection, trying to establish so many relationships. But ultimately, the constitutional nature of the soul is to attain pure divine Krishna prem, love, priti, and affection for the Absolute Truth. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he came exclusively to declare this fact to the whole human society, that ordinarily there are four goals given in the Vedas, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. That means dharma, religiosity, artha, economic development, kama, sense gratification, and moksha, ultimately attaining liberation from the cycle of birth and death. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said that there is a fifth goal for all human beings, and what is that? Prema Pumarto Mahan. This is the great ultimate goal of all human society. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and demonstrated this. He is Prem Purushottam. Who is he? He is Sri Sri Radha and Krishna combined in one form. And he is actually Nandanandan Krishna, completely overwhelmed by the mood and the bhav and kanti of Srimati Radharani, who, as Srila Gurudev just told, is the Unnata Ujjvala Rasa. She is the queen of Vrindavan, who serves Krishna in the highest way in Parakya Bhav. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came into this world to give this highest form of Krishna prema,
but it cannot be directly given what those moods and that Mahabhav praying and Madanakya Mahabhav, which is experienced by Srimati Radharani, the Jiva souls do not have the eligibility for this praying because of their small constitutional nature. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, as Srila Gurudev so wonderfully described, to give this very special variety of this Krishna praying as Swa Bhakti Shriyam. Hare Krishna.
Arattho Bhagavan Pradesh Tanayastat Dham Vrindavan Ramya Kachitu Pasana Padu Padu Parge Naja Kalpita Srimad Bhagavata Pramana Amalam Prema Kumartho Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matamidam Tatradaro Nahapara Nahapara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling. Who is telling? Chakravarti Thakur. This is not Chakravarti Thakur. First was by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by Tattva. And now it is given through Rasa, Rasa Tattva. Aradhyo Bhagavan Prajesha Tanaya. Our Aradhya Dev, worshipable, most worshipable, is Krishna? No. Prajendra Nandan Krishna. Yashoda Nandan Krishna. Radhika Raman, Rash Bihari Krishna. Radha Khan. So he is Bhagavan. But he has come as a son of Nanda Baba Yashoda Maiya. He is most beloved of gopis, especially of Srimati Radhika. As Krishna is worshipable, Vrindavan Dham is also, because without Vrindavan, Krishna cannot play anywhere himself. He can play in other forms, but Nandan, with gopis, only Vrindavan Dham. What is Vrindavan? Krishna has become Dham, Vrindavan Dham, especially Baladev Prabhu is Dham. So, Krishna is Aradhya, who is playing always in Vrindavan with Prajavasi, especially with gopis. Ramya Kachut Upasana Baju Baju Bargaina Jakalpita. How gopis have worshipped and pleased Krishna. This is the highest aradhana upasana. Anything is not equal to this aradhana. Even Uddhava, like bhakta of Krishna, he has prayed gopis, has prepared. Even the ladies of even the Mathura in the wrestling concert, when they saw fighting so much daitya, and then they began to tell, we should not stay here. Those who are dharmatma, religious person, they should give up this place. And then they are telling how Vrindavan is glorious because of gopis. Rudha bhava, they have a rudha bhava. Rudha bhava means sneha, man, pranay, raga, anurag, vidha. Anywhere you cannot see without gopis. So, the upasana, the aradhana of gopi, that they can take the heart of Krishna and control by their love and affection. Krishna cannot repay them, never. He is telling, for na pare ham nirvadya sanjujan ma bhajanati durjana griha shinkhala sambrishya tatva pratyati sadhana. O gopis, my most beloved. I cannot be in life of Brahma or more than that. Never. You should please mercifully to me. I cannot be there. How we can be there? If Krishna will tell them, oh, you should have any broom? Broom? Broom. What the gopi will ask? Oh, we can, any service you should give. Not for their pleasure. Oh, only to please Krishna. Then Krishna will. Gopis will tell, as we have left our whole family, our husband, son, and everything, only for you. Can you give up everything, your mother, father, and all devotees, for us? Krishna cannot do. He cannot do. He cannot give up any bhakta. So he went also to Mathura, here and there. Where they will call, he must go. Je jathan mam prapadanti tam tathaiva bhajam meham. He is bound to do. So he, Krishna, cannot do. So Aradhana's gopi is supermost. And praying to Krishna is most superior. We don't want to see only Krishna. Kansa, Jarasandha, and so many saw Krishna. Duryodhana saw. What we can? If there is no prem, so our prayojan is prem, not Krishna. So you should know all these things. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling that Praman is Srimad Bhagavatam. Among all Shruti, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Mahabharata, Ramayana, everywhere, the essence of all Shruti, all Puran, Brahma Sutra, everything is Srimad Bhagavatam. The Srimad Bhagavatam, Pramana, Amalam, this is Amal. Amal means?
Spotless.
Spotless. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this is his chief teaching. And in the art I want to tell you, the sub and substance of all the teachings that Rupa Goswami has written. Tannama Sukirtananu Kramena Rasana Manasi Niyodya Tishthan Bhraje Tadanuragi Jananugami Kalam Naye Tikhilam Ityupadesha Sara. Remember this thing. Tannama Rupa Charitadi. The Krishna name of Braja is according to his past sweet pastimes. Damodar. Yashoda Damodar or Radha Damodar. Yashoda mother binded him. And gopis binded Krishna with the veil of Radhika. In Ghatholi, there is a place in Braja. God holy man? That Krishna cannot go here and there. He will always be with you. So he is Radha Damodar. Namami Ishwaram is for Yashoda Damodar. And in the end shloka, what he has? Namo Radhikaya Tadiya Priyaya Namo Nanta Leelaya Devaya. So this is our goal. So he is telling that you should chant these names, Damodar, Rash Pihari, when he is doing Rash, and so many things. All names due to his sweet pastimes. All these names and Naam, Roop, Gun, Leela, all in mind. in her. By 10, you should chant all these names, sing all these names, and in the heart you should remember these sweet pastimes of Krishna. Tannam Rupa Charitadi Sukrtananu. Hearing from any bona fide guru or Vaishnavas, in their guidance, those who are rasik, tattva, knowing all kinds of tattva, being especially in Vrindavan. If you cannot be in Vrindavan, by mind you can be there. But better, one day you will have to go to Vrindavan. So you will have to go to Vrindavan. But if you cannot go, by mind you should be always in Vrindavan. Oh, meditate. Vrinda is very beautiful. Yamuna is flowing there. Both sides, Beli, Chaveli, Yui, Vrinda Devi, flowers. Bees are humming. Cuckoos are singing. Peacocks are dancing. Krishna is playing there. Without Vrindavan he can. So, always remember these things. Tannam Rupa Charitadi Sukrtananu Kramena Rasana Manasi Niyojya Tishan Braje Braj mein rahte huye, being in Vrindavan. Tishan Braje Tadanuragi. You should be in under the guidance of any Rasik and Tattva Vaishnava. Don't live free. You must be under the guidance of Tattva and Rasik. And if you are doing like so, very soon Krishna Prem, Gopi Prem, Braj Prem will come. This is the last essence of all the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gaur Premanamandir, Yasodas, any Kirtan, and then
Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore
Hasti Yashoda, Tanaya Prasida.
Vallabhi Jeevan Radhike Sa Shri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhike Sa Shri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhike Sa Shri Vallabhi Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Sri Krishna
Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna
Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Sri Krishna
Gopal Hare Mukunda
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Please sit down. Please be seated. Hare Krishna, today Srila Gurudev has given some initiation. Now we'll announce your name, spiritual name.
Nicholas Keller, please stand up.
Nanda Gopal Prabhu ki
this morning. Anju Singhal receiving Harinam this morning. Anju.
Anjali. Anjali Devi ki
then from New Jersey, New York. Ajoy Pandey receiving initiation. Asha Pandey. Sunita Pandey and Nilam Da. Stand up. Ajay.
Asalata. Asalata ki. Sunita Devi ki, Neelam Devi ki.
Then the devotees who were in the fire sacrifice while Bhagavan Prabhu will make some presentation, please carefully come forward and offer your dakshina to Srila Gurudev.
Hare Krishna. So, unfortunately, this wonderful Harikatha will temporarily come to a close. Just shifting to a new place. We'll be shifting to LA and Badger and many other places. Srila Gurudev will be bringing his Harikatha caravan from one place to another around the world. Traveling roadshow. Just like Krishna is traveling from universe to universe, Gurudev is traveling throughout this universe, throughout this planet, giving us Harikatha. There were many devotees who worked together with myself and Mahabodhi in order to put on this festival. It was a big endeavor, but to see so many devotees come here and get Srila Gurudev's mercy was a big reward for both of us. I wanted to name a few of the people that worked with me, and also Mahabodhi wants to name some of the people that worked. We want to point out some of the devotees that helped out here in the Prashadam area. We want to give a great thanks to Anadi Krishna Das, who helped supervise the Prashad distribution 3 times a day. Also, Lakshmi Pati Das, who helped with Prashad distribution every day. Gayadev Das, who helped with Prashad distribution every day. Uddharan Das, who did Prashad distribution every day along with his wife. Is that his name? I don't know his name yet. I apologize. Our two security persons who... Toughest job, most difficult job. Sanatan Das and Madhusudan Das. I want to give them a big hand for the work they did with this community. I also want to thank Jalakar Prabhu for loaning us the Vyasasan, and Trilochan Prabhu for taking the responsibility of driving it here and driving it back. I also want to thank Isha Das, who spends every minute that he's awake, practically, working hard on organizing Srila Gurudev's videos, the DVDs, the lectures, and he came here to do the webcasting, and, I mean, the guy, he does a great service. All the devotees should go to the webcasting and make a little donation to help Isha Das, who works for absolutely nothing, just the service of Srila Gurudev and his mercy. I want to also thank Shama Sundar and Bhakti Vinod for doing filming. They did a lot of filming and assistance with each of that. And I want to thank Shama Sundar and his good wife, Bimala Dasi, for the great job they did on taking care of the deities and being with the jealous. And we want to give a big round of applause, of course, to our favorite Kirtaniya, Krishna Das, for the great kirtan that he did. And I also want to personally thank Indupati, who led the Sankirtan party out for 3 days, distributing about 500 different literatures and over 500 bags of prasadam to the conditioned souls out on the beaches. Great service that he did doing the Sankirtan every day. And another prasad person was Paramananda Das. I want to thank him for the prasad favor that he did. And now I'm going to hand this over to Mahabodhi because he's got a list of people that he knows.
Hare Krishna. Srila Gurudev had asked, we had some question of what about the festival we had called him, because there were some concerns about his health at that time, and we heard from the background the yelling coming back is, no, I want big festival. So Bhagavat and I were kind of going, uh-oh.
Are you going to come? He said,
yes, I can come. Why I won't come? I will come.
Today said, because both Bhagavat Prabhu and Mahabodhi are very big personalities, it should be the biggest festival ever.
Hare Krishna. First of all and foremost, I'd like to thank Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, who without his presence, no one would be here, and was, and is so kindly taken the opportunity to give us his association, and we are so thankful and so grateful. The devotees in South Florida have had opportunities of association for April and May. So we for us now it is growing very sad. Even though he's here, the thought of his going is making us tremble. So we're hoping that he will come back again sometime and visit with us. So there are also some devotees who have to be mentioned. This festival would not be actually a festival without their help. And Bhagavad Prabhu listed some of the devotees. Some of these devotees who listed here are, put their time and effort and money and everything to make this happen so all of these guests could come and hear Srila Gurudev. And not only Srila Gurudev, but I also would like to thank all of our sannyasis and Prayagrojana and all of the sannyasis, Padmanabh Maharaj, Arsajan Maharaj, Madhav Maharaj, Shoti Maharaj, Ramadhar Maharaj, Radandi Maharaj, our sincere thanks and gratitude because the not only was Srila
Chamarani.
Chamarani. Not only was the opportunity of the festival that we're hearing so much wonderful things from Srila Gurudev, but those of you who attended classes, the classes were wonderful. None of the classes in Kirtan. So our gratitude please goes out and thanks very from the core of our hearts for visiting with us here and allowing us also to have your darshan and hear from your lordship that you've heard from Srila Gurudev. So we very much thank you all. Because I don't think that I may have been taking too much time, but if I don't mention some of these devotees, I will be a very offensive because this whole opportunity is commanded by the word. I'd also like to thank Radhasham and Yasoda Dasi for registration, Gulari Dasi for the books, Jagannath and Balaram Das who transported all the devotees, along with Raghunath to get here. Jamuna Dasi, and I think that Gopadev Das, who served all of the sannyasis and all of our guests here, has been to Publix about 50 times the time here, helping everyone. Leelanath Prabhu, and now there are three families here that are the cornerstones of here. Shashikalan Raghunath Das, and then Kamalan Vasudev Das, who put in their time running. And also we would like to thank Raghunath Prabhu, and Miami, who actually hosted Srila Gurudev for an entire month. Hare Krishna, thank you very much. And Sudarshan Prabhu who helped with all the sound system. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare.
Thank you for coming and visiting the webcast live from South Florida. Radhe Shyam Jai Shri Gurudev.